yeah, let's go a bit more deep upon this Goldman Sachs internship experience. Do you have any idea of the web technologies? Okay, what is your understanding about the round robin algorithm? Yeah. Hi, Shivang. How are you?
Yeah. Hello. I'm good.
Okay, great. So let's start. I'll give a quick brief about myself and then you can go ahead telling about you and your experiences and all. Okay. So myself, Shubham, I graduated from IIT Roorkee itself like 4 years back. And then I worked in a couple of startup and MNC as a software and precisely a front end developer. I started my journey from OYO, where I primarily worked on the oyrooms.com website, working on major integrations with other teams like Google, PhonePe and all. And a lot more on the search engine optimization side. So that was an experience, quick one on the OYO. And then I moved to an early stage startup to get an idea at a very basic level or a very small team how things work. So that's a bit and pieces about me and primarily the front end experience that I hold it. Can you give a brief intro about yourself?
I am a fourth year undergraduate student pursuing electrical engineering from IIT Roorkee. Mm-hmm. And I'm from Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. And my interests mainly lie in the field of data structures and algorithms, competitive programming, mm-hmm. and software development. Mm-hmm. And I've been doing competitive programming since the last 2 years, and I really enjoy it a lot. And apart from this, I've interned at Goldman Sachs and Samsung Research okay. Institute, Bangalore, and mm-hmm. and also at a startup called Newzera Techlab.
Yeah, let's go a bit more deep upon this Goldman Sachs internship experience.
Okay. So basically, what I had to do in that internship, like there was a single project given, and I was supposed to work on that project for 2 months. So the project was basically to design an API that can convert instrument files to router files. Like instrument files basically are details of stock market tradables. So mm-hmm. basically my role was to convert this particular stock into the router file. And a router file is basically a file which has all the details about the basically, it's kind of expected value of that stock. Like, is it going to be beneficial or not? Like, this is a very brief idea about this. In detail, okay. I guess this is very complex. And so basically, earlier what they used to do is, like to convert an instrument file to router file, there are certain steps that are to be followed. Like,
okay, so if you are not very clear about the what all the machine learning or the other algorithm, prediction algorithms that were designed, how were you able to optimize that part? Like what are the key features that you were working on the optimization part?
Okay, no, I was not working on the optimization part. What I was working was to design an API to automate this process.
So I think you have the interview pad link, right?
Yeah, sure.
Can you quickly open and share the screen? Let's suppose there is a very common problem of file downloading order. So what is that? Or I think the synonyms, do you have any idea of the web technologies? As in like, JavaScript, HTML, CSS, something of that sort. So file downloading order is that it says that let's suppose there is a file A which can be downloaded only if file B and file C is already downloaded. Okay. Are you getting what I'm saying? Or better, the way I have made the arrow, let's make it that way. That I can say that file B can be downloaded. File A can be downloaded after file B and file A can be downloaded after file C. Okay. And even let me write it much simpler that after B and C only the file A can be downloaded.
Okay.
Looks pretty clean, right?
Yep.
And let's suppose my file C can be downloaded only after file D has been downloaded. That means in an order, are you getting? Like after C is downloaded, then the E could be downloaded. It just follow the arrow, right? B and C is downloaded only then A can be downloaded. When C is downloaded only after that, D can be downloaded. If you try to make a graph, you can see a directed graph coming up, right? Yeah. So like A is dependent on B and C, D is dependent on C and so on, right?
Yeah.
So you don't have to code this thing and I don't want to go in the adjacency matrix and list format. I want to know like, how would you solve this problem when there is a lot of file dependency and you have to decide like, okay, how is going to be the download order?
Okay.
Yeah.
So like we can basically apply a topological sorting algorithm in this case. So mm-hmm. that will basically just like topological sorting is simply the reverse of the depth first search, depth first search order of traversal. So basically mm-hmm. like in this case, we'll first add directed edges from the nodes on which other nodes depend. Like in this case, we will add a directed edge from A to C and another one from A to B. Then we will add another directed edge from D to C. Now, let's say we start DFS from any of our nodes. Let's say we start a DFS from node C. So like we will see that like since there is like no node that is the no edge that is coming out from C, we will move to some other node. Then let's say we move to B, then also.
So in short, like, you are kind of implementing the topological sorting order. The one which is having no dependency, you print that first, get it out of the stack or some other like any space that you are consuming.
I just said that I just set the visited array of that. Like I'm keeping a visited array which is going to store whether this particular node is visited or not. And if it is visited, like I'm not going to start a DFS from it again. And if it's not visited, then I'm going to start a DFS from it. Like first, I'm going to travel all the nodes. And if any of the nodes is not visited, I'm going to start a DFS from it.
Okay.
And Yeah.
So if I just add one more question here, that if I want to know that what is the number of possible ways in which a file downloading order could be present? Like there need not be only one way, right? There could be multiple ways. If you already know that topological sorting order can have multiple outcomes. Okay.
Yes.
So if I want to know like what could be a possible number of outcomes from after the topological sorting, can you tell me how would you find it? Again, verbally, you don't have to code anything and so on.
Okay. Okay. Let me just think on it.
Have you solved any sort of problem before where you need to, it's just that what all possible DFS. So it's just that what are the number of paths that you can make from a, you know, head to bottom that way well. So anyways, just try to code somewhere, maybe later. I think,
I think we can solve this using dynamic programming. Like we can just store on each of the nodes. Like first we're going to, like in this case, we'll have to going to be specifically starting from the nodes which do not have any edge that enter into them. And we'll run a DFS from all those nodes. And then basically, like we are going to set initially the DP of this node to be equal to one because there is only one path from this node to the current node. And then as we move forward,
Okay, so yeah, I think that was good. So have you gone through the database and OS courses?
Okay, I have not studied the database course, but I have studied the operating systems course last semester.
Okay, database is something that we can discuss or not at all?
Like I'm not very much familiar with database.
Okay, no issues. So if I ask about the OS part, you know, there is a very frequently sockets being used, right? So I just wanted to know one use case that you think at which the sockets can be used. So when we say about this scheduling algorithms, there are very multiple scheduling algorithms. So let's particularly talk about the round robin. Can you tell me some of the real life examples, or maybe you can tell in terms of the computer network and all, the any use case of the round robin algorithm?
I think it is used to manage like all the multiple windows that we open in our computer. One second. Like I.
Okay. What is your understanding about the round robin algorithm? If you first tell that part.
Okay. So basically, it is used to like run processes in multitasking. Basically.
Okay. I think I had a lot more questions, but we can wrap it here. And that's formally an end of an interview from my side. You have any questions you want to ask? Okay, great. Thanks a lot, Shivang.